Summer's fast approaching, and just like the hot weather of summer, a lot of hot and interesting soccer news happened in our beloved Atlanta, Georgia this past week. On Thursday, after careful deliberation, the Atlanta United FC management has finally named the new head coach of Atlanta United 2, who will replace Tony Annan, the interim manager who officially left the club this week after agreeing to become South Carolina's men's soccer coach. According to reports, anytime this week, Atlanta United FC president Darren Eales is set to name former West Ham player Jack Collison as the new top bench tactician of the United 2. Collison has been part of the United 2 coaching staff since 2019. The ex-Hammer had more than 100 appearances for the Hammers in both the English Premier League and Championship divisions before finishing his playing career with stints at Bournemouth, Wigan, and Peterborough. As a former player, Collison is expected to have a good coaching career for United 2 and a good relationship with the young players of the academy. Also on Thursday, after the dust settled, Kalonji Profile was declared as the 2021 United Premier Soccer League, that's the UPSL, Georgia Premier Division champions. Profile got the championship after beating LSA Limeño 3-0 in the finals last May 30th at South Gwinnett Park in Snellville. The Profile, who were very determined to win the championship, started strong, scoring their first goal on 36 minutes. They then played tough defense and foiled any goal attempts from Limeño. On their official Facebook page, the Profile cited hard work and discipline as the keys to their championship win. Hard work pays off, commitment brings opportunities, discipline is about consistency, and loyalty brings you success and opportunities, the site said. The UPSL is a mostly United States-based professional development soccer league that was founded in Santa Ana in Southern California, with teams in regionalized conferences throughout the United States and recently Canada and Mexico. The league was founded in 2011 by Santa Ana Winds FC president Lionel Lopez as a regional league for teams in Greater Los Angeles, but expanded to include teams from 32 states as of the 2019 UPSL season. On Friday, it was learned that the scheduled June 12th friendly soccer match between Latin rivals Mexico and Honduras soccer teams at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium is expected to be a blockbuster affair. According to reports, 8 days before the highly anticipated soccer game, more than 50,000 tickets have already been sold. Due to the high demand of people wanting to attend in this post-pandemic time, the organizers are now opening the upper deck. If the trend of hot ticket sales continues, it could break the record-setting 70,511 tickets sold or distributed in Mexico's 2-1 win over Panama in the semifinals of the Gold Cup, again at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium, back in 2015. As we had reported earlier, former Atlanta United FC manager and current Mexico national team manager, Tata Martino, is confident his team can continue its winning tradition when they play the Honduran team on June 12th around 7:30 p.m. at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Also on Friday, it was learned that one of the teams in the Mexican Soccer League is seriously seeking the services of Atlanta United FC's 22-year-old Argentine winger, Ezequiel Barco. According to reports, Club America is planning to negotiate with United for the transfer of Barco to the team in exchange for Nicolas Benedetti, who fell out of grace with the Mexican Soccer Club. Club America is reportedly shopping Benedetti to Atlanta since they're unhappy with his recent performances and injuries. Sources say United's not too keen to let go of Barco, and neither are we fans, since he is a vital part of Gabriel Ainsa's system. United are fully aware of the skills of Barco and his enormous potential in the market, estimated at in excess of 10 million euros, which is about $10.2 million. Atlanta acquired Barco in 2018 for 12 million euros. Benedetti is valued at around 2.5 million. Barco made headlines this week after he was called up to the Argentina U23 national team by manager Fernando Batista for two matches against Denmark on June 8th and Saudi Arabia on June 11th. The two matches in Marbella, Spain, a nice part of the world, are part of the U23 group's preparations for the Tokyo Olympics. On Monday, a piece of good news for all Atlanta United 2 fans as they started the month of June strong with a 1-0 home win against Louisville City FC Sunday night at Fifth Third Bank Stadium. United 2 striker Aidan McFadden bounced back from a lackluster performance in the team's 1-0 defeat against Birmingham Legion FC on May 30th at home. He scored the lone goal for United 2 for a morale-boosting win and a solid start for new head coach Jack Collison. Playing in front of their home fans, Collison and his crew started strong and scored the game-winning goal on the 26th minute. The visiting Louisville 11 tried to catch up and played with lots of energy in the second half, but United 2 goalkeeper Alec Khan was at his best and foiled all of their attempts. Khan had 7 saves on 8 shots on goal, en route to his first shutout of the season. United 2, who are 3-2-2 with 11 points, hope to continue their winning ways when they host the dangerous Sporting KC 11 June 9th here at home. That will be on ESPN Plus at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Also on Monday, Atlanta Soccer News learned that an estimated 111 soccer teams from all across the United States are set to join the 2021 Beer City Cup at the Memorial Stadium in North Carolina. According to the organizers of the nation's biggest adult soccer event, the participation exceeds the 92 teams they had expected, prompting them to consider adding another venue for the event, slated for September 3rd through the 5th this year. Co-directors David Turner and Eric Usher said they hope to name the additional venue and additional details on the soccer event this Friday, June the 11th. Soccer fans who will attend the tournament, many of whom will come from here, are not expected to wear masks anymore since the mask requirement for outdoor sports was lifted by the governor of North Carolina. A lot of teams are joining this year's event, co-sponsored by Asheville City Soccer Club, since it offers beer, soccer, and cash to both participants and fans. On Tuesday, 2 talented midfielders from Georgia Gwinnett College men's and women's soccer teams are set to be honored for academic excellence by the College Sports Information Directors of America. Recent men's soccer graduate Alfredo Rivera and rising senior women's soccer player Addie Adame were recognized as academic all-district selections for showing outstanding performance, not only on the soccer field, but in the classroom as well. The 2 players, who are midfielders from Lilburn, Rivera played at Brookwood and Adame at Parkview, were picked by a vote by district sports information directors from among candidates who had a 3.3 or higher cumulative grade point average, had attended their current institution for a full calendar year, and met criteria based on career statistics. Rivera had a stellar collegiate career as he established a new program record this past spring season with 13 assists in helping the Grizzlies post an unbeaten regular season and a top 10 national ranking. The talented midfielder also appeared in 70 matches from 2017 to 21, tallying 5 goals and 21 assists, helping teams win 2 conference titles and playing in the NAIA tournament during all 4 seasons. Like Rivera, Adame is also superb in her collegiate soccer career, as she was named the most outstanding player of the Association of Independent Institutions 2020 through 21 championship tournament and earned all-conference honors. She helped the Grizzlies capture the conference title, scoring a penalty kick goal in the team's semifinal victory and also converting a penalty kick during the shootout in their championship match triumph. Adame has scored 6 goals and contributed 6 assists in 52 career matches. Also on Tuesday, Hammers beat the Gunners in the Roswell Over 50 Championship with a 4-3 thriller. The Roswell Over 50s Men's Soccer League is part of the flourishing senior soccer community based in North Metro Atlanta. There we see both men and women playing both competitively and recreationally in Over 59, Over 65, and Over 70 divisions, with a few men still turning out as old as 82 and 83 years old. They continue to inspire youngsters such as myself in my 60s. Well, it's been another busy week as far as soccer happenings are concerned on this side of the country. Thank you so much for watching. Make it always a habit to watch us weekly on YouTube and our social media handles. Also, make it a point to visit us on our website at atlantasoccer.news. Keep safe always, guys. And enjoy your soccer. Until next time, this is Alan Vaughan for Atlanta Soccer News saying bye for now.